This segment of the news is brought to you by Journey to Recovery. Take the first step. Call 775-382-1072. News is also brought to you by Smitty's Cards and Coins. Would you like to know what your collectibles are worth? Come by 2281 Postal Road, Unit 4, across from the post office.
At the last Board of County Commissioners meeting, on the agenda was an item addressing Pahrump Valley Disposal and their agreement for trash collection and disposal here in Pahrump. Some language has changed in this new agreement, like the word recycling. Business owner Renee Morales has been in contention for several years regarding the agreement between the county and Pahrump Valley Disposal. He is not happy with the new agreement, saying that Nevada law does not allow for an exclusive monopoly on recycling. Morales has been for years accusing Pahrump Valley Disposal of not paying the county the correct amount of tipping fees for construction trucks that are dumping trash in the landfill.
Item number 9, which is a continued public hearing, discussion and deliberation to adopt, amend and adopt, or reject Nye County Bill 2017-14, a bill proposing to amend Title 8 of the Nye County Code, and then there's a big line of everything that mentions everything in the code, and I'm not reading all that. So, commissioners, is there a motion on this, so we can open the public hearing after that?
Mr. Chairman, I'd make a motion to adopt the proposed bill and recommend adoption of the amendment to the, what was that? I can't read my writing now. Proposed bill.
There's a motion to second. And there's a second. There's a motion to adopt the proposed bill and the amendments to the proposed bill.
You need to reread that section again. Of he had the exclusive franchise of solid waste and recyclables. Now he's taking all the competition out as a whole. You're giving more power to this guy than have used the existing landfill, taxpayer landfill, for his personal gain. Our landfill is full in Soto Yanche's pockets. He has stolen more than $20 million from, and Mrs. Pamwell who agree with me, and now you're gonna give more power? How dare you guys? This is ridiculous. You know what? These type of criminals, they need to be put in jail and throw that key away.
Hold on now. You're starting to get a little...
I'm saying the truth.
As you see it?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I don't sugarcoat it.
But calling somebody a criminal is...
I am.
Okay, you're on okay. The record.
I'm calling the things by their own name. Truth is a little uncomfortable sometimes, but he owns Pahrump Valley Disposal, he owns a recycled facility, Yo Sanitation, and we pay him $1 million, Southwest Environmental Services, the county pay him to rob us. He never charged himself, and I give Mrs. Pam Wester over $100,000 worth in evidence, county records, video evidence, and also to the district attorney. It's an ongoing investigation with the sheriff's department for a multi-million dollar scam on John Shea. You guys want to hear the truth? This is the truth. Don't give him this monopoly. Don't extend the monopoly anymore.
Hold on, Mr. DA.
I was just about to interject.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please do.
Yeah, per our the little blurb at the beginning of our agenda, we can't, we can't talk about people who aren't here, so.
Thank you. That's what I was trying to get to. I just needed somebody else to say it.
Just to clarify, if I
yes,
could.
Yes, please do clarify.
If you look under Chapter 8, 24, 310, under each individual letter subsection, yep. It actually says that construction or demolition debris may be removed by any duly licensed construction or demolition contractor. That takes care of that. A person may transport their own solid waste to the sanitation. And then the next page talks about commercial recyclers. So I just wanted to make sure that was clear for the record that,
thank you.
That
thank you.
People have those available.
Thank you for clarifying the record.
Sometimes they don't read what they want to read.
And President Donald Trump decided to remove Anthony Scaramucci from his role as communications director today. Scaramucci was reportedly escorted from the White House just 2 weeks after he got the job. The White House said Mr. Scaramucci felt it was best to give Chief of Staff John Kelly a clean slate and the ability to build his own team. It's not clear if he will hold any other position under this administration. His arrival led to the resignations of Sean Spicer, former press secretary, along with Rents Priebus, former chief of staff. A two-car crash occurred this afternoon on Basin Avenue.
A two-vehicle accident occurred on Basin and Emery Street this afternoon between a white pickup truck and a brown Kia. How the rear-end collision occurred is under the investigation of the Nye County Sheriff's Office. However, Pahrump Valley Fire and Rescue did check out two occupants inside the Kia who declined to be transported to local medical facilities. Both vehicles sustained moderate damage and were moved off the roadway quickly. No one inside the pickup truck claimed any injury at the time of the collision. This is Deanna O'Donnell for News 46.
And a vehicle caught fire in the Walmart parking lot over the weekend.
Pahrump Valley Fire Rescue and Nye County Sheriff's deputies were dispatched to the south parking lot of Walmart yesterday for what was reported as a car fire with some type of fireworks also going off inside the vehicle. Upon arrival, deputies located that the passenger seat of the car was actually on fire. By the time that fire crews arrived on scene, the car was completely engulfed in flames. No injuries were reported at the time of the fire. How the fire started is under the investigation of Pahrump Valley Fire and Rescue and appears to be accidental in nature. This is Deanna O'Donnell for News 46.
And after this break, we'll have what's happening in news across the state and today's Angie's List report.